opportunity for Heavy Metal Van Hammer, who has been on a serious roll here in WCW.
And Eric, I like the way that he came to the ring. Now, he understands that he's stepping in with the United States Heavyweight Champion, Rick Rude. He didn't jump up in them ropes running around shaking hands because he knows, brother, this is business.
I saw a look of confidence, however, in the eyes of Heavy Metal Van Hammer that I think has been lacking at least the early part of his career in WCW. I think Heavy Metal Van Hammer, finally, he's putting it all together. Obviously, he's got the physical attributes, but the psychological aspect of this sport is so critical.
Well, Eric, you know, this is his second time facing Ravaging Rick Rude. Now, he went to the promoters. He wanted this thing signed. So, brother, he got it.
And Rick Rude, not taking Heavy Metal Van Hammer lightly here. Certainly, Heavy Metal Van Hammer possesses the strength, as we're seeing here, to upset the U.S. Heavyweight Champion. The question is whether or not he'll be able to stick to his game plan. Oopsie. Yeah. Ran right into a knee there. Double thrust to the throat.
Well, one thing that Hammer's got to do now, he's got to slow it down. You know, don't get overconfident, because Rude, the seasoned veteran as he is, brother, he'll lay right in play possum, and Hammer will make a mistake.
And again, seeing the power of Heavy Metal Van Hammer, I tell you, you can't help it when you look at this match, wonder what's going to happen. It's Starrcade 92 Battle of the Lethal Lottery. If these two would end up on the same team.
Well,
now Heavy Metal Van Hammer hooks a leg. Two just about had a huge, and I mean huge, upset.
And that's what you got to do. You see, he had Rude dazed. He'd give him four or five of those clotheslines. He was dazed. He got right on him for the cover.
Back body drop and then a leg drop right across the chin. Again, Heavy Metal Van Hammer hooking the leg, and again a two count. Now, here's where Hammer's got to be careful, Teddy. He can't allow himself to get frustrated, can he?
Well, he has to pay more attention to what's going on here.
And now Ravishing Rick Rude.
Well, if I was Hammer, I'd right behind him right there. I'd have hooked him, tried to catch him in a pinning predicament.
Heavy Metal Van Hammer in serious trouble here as Ravishing Rick Rude positions himself, hooks the leg, but did not get the three counts. Rick Rude sets up. Snap suplex on the big man. And Ravishing Rick Rude, again, in a pinning predicament, but again, fails to get his weight directly over the shoulders. And with a man the size and the strength of Van Hammer, that very critical.
Well, you can see Rude now. He snatches a rear ten lock right here, Eric, so he can kind of cut the air supply off a little bit.
Looks to me like the inside of that wrist is precariously close to the throat area. The referee looking very closely to make sure that this chin lock or face lock does not turn into a chokehold. And Medusa, rather ominous in her own way at ringside.
Well, Hammer right now, he's trying to get some daylight. If he can get back to his feet, he may get the advantage, but Rude is doing a good job. He's keeping him down, but he's on one knee, but oh, he makes it up.
Now, Heavy Metal Van Hammer taking advantage of the daylight between himself and Ravishing Rick Rude. Two elbows to the midsection, but it's a rake to the eyes by the laces on that boot. Ravishing Rick Rude back in control, and then an elbow.
And what we're looking at in Rude is experience.
He is definitely controlling the pace of the contest, and that's so critical in a matchup when you have two athletes of this caliber. He who controls the pace has the best chance of winning the contest, and right now it is Ravishing Rick Rude. Definitely in control, but a reversal. And then a sweeper by Heavy Metal Van Hammer. Heavy Metal Van Hammer.
Well, this might be it, but you better watch Rude. He'll run him right back into that turnbuckle. He'll cause him to break that if he can get the momentum going.
I don't think so. Heavy Metal Van Hammer, with the strength that he has, I believe that this could be it, Teddy. What a win this would be for Heavy Metal Van Hammer.
Well, I tell you, you may be right, Eric. I believe Rude's on the way out, but I think he's fighting it with everything he's got right here.
Well, I don't think he's got enough left. He is about a heartbeat away from taking a nap the hard way. Heavy Metal Van Hammer clanking now on that sleeper. All of the pressure on the carotid artery cuts off the oxygen to the brain. You see the legs giving out. What a win this will be for Heavy Metal Van Hammer here on the Power Hour.
Well, I think it's all she wrote for Rude. Referee better check him. I think that's it.
Checking the arm. Three strikes, you're out of here. One down, two to go. Medusa looking on. Two, you hear the crowd count it. And here we go.
Well, wait a minute. Now talk about experience. Rude is fighting with all he's got. Took his feet and put it on the bottom rope. But did Medusa do that?
Ah, oh, man. Now, Heavy Metal Van Hammer, though, maintains control. You see him, he dragged Ravishing Rick Rude back to the center of the ring. But now Rude up. Wait a minute. Rude coming up.
Well, he's going to snap that neck.
Oh! Jawbreaker.
Now, that's what Rude needs, some daylight right here. Now, you watch him. He's going to try and recover from that sleeper. But Hammer certainly got his neck snapped there. Wow, and he gives it right back to Rude.
Oh, look at the power. Look at the power. Heavy Metal Van Hammer picks Rude up, drops him.
Well, right here.
Oh, no, here we go.
I believe he's going to set it for that slingshot right here, Eric. Oh, this is all she wrote for Rude.
Oh, Rude reverses the slingshot suplex, and it's the Rude away.